Hello, good evening and welcome to the Mop Top Tours Christmas Show 2021. Yes, good evening and welcome to my living room. It's Stevie T here with you from the Mop Top Tours. That's Liverpool's favourite Beatles tour, bringing you this evening the Mop Top Tours Christmas Show 2021. And this is a rather special Christmas show this year because this one we are doing in aid of our chosen charity, which this year is the Stroke Association. One of our dear friends, Mr. Bill Smith, who is the sole surviving founder member of the Quarrymen Skiffle Group, suffered a stroke a couple of months ago in late 2021. And with that in mind, we decided to do this as a fundraiser for the Stroke Association this year. So we do hope you'll be able to support our chosen charity. If you would like to make a donation this evening, check out the link below the video and you'll find that will take you through to our Just Giving page. Whatever amount you can manage will be appreciated. There's no amount that will be too small for us, so please do click that link below and that will take you through to our Just Giving page for the Stroke Association. So what have we got lined up for you tonight? Well, we've got all kinds of good stuff coming your way. We have got music, we've got videos, we've got our memories of 2021. We have a free prize draw with some wonderful prizes up for grabs this evening. So I do hope you'll stay with us join in with all the fun on the show tonight. Anyway, to kick us off this evening, a rather special video we've got lined up for you, which was created about a month ago, actually, during the Mersey Festival of Light, the Liverpool Festival of Light, which took place down in Liverpool city centre and along the waterfront. It was a fantastic event. And we took a bit of video footage whilst we were down there. And this has all been put together by our technical man, Mr. Pino Lo Giudice, who's based in Reggio Calabria in Italy, one of our regular Mop Top Tour guests who we work very closely with. And Pino has put this video together for us of the Liverpool Festival of Light. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Wasn't that wonderful? The Liverpool Festival of Light 2021. It's a fantastic event. It comes on, I think, annually now, usually in November. We've been down there the last couple of years and very much enjoyed it. So if you do get to Liverpool around this time of year, certainly give it a try. And and thanks very much to Pino over in Reggio Calabria for putting that wonderful video together, and to the Lagoodles for providing the music soundtrack. And we'll have more from the Lagoodles later on in the show. Anyway, coming up next, a little word about stroke.
So I was in work, it was a Friday.
It was my 7th birthday party.
There's something not right and I start to panic.
My mind was not coming together.
I can't move my right hand today.
Massive sharp pain.
Explosion.
My brain fell out.
Thought I would die.
My body drained. And then I disappeared.
I woke up and everything was spinning.
The light was like needles.
Your life is in a trap.
Over time, it's getting better.
Hopefully some of these fingers might work again.
Every day is a challenge.
You need that extra support to get you through.
I am Baz.
I'm Paul.
I'm Luna. I'm a stroke survivor.
I am a stroke survivor.
I'm Alicia, and I'm a stroke survivor.
Well, a massive thank you to everyone who's made a donation to our chosen charity this evening, which is the Stroke Association. Now, you may be wondering what inspired us to do this for the Stroke Association this year. Well, it was really as a result of one of our dear friends suffering a stroke a few weeks ago. And this person, some of you will actually know, you'll have seen him on some of our videos that we've done. And if you've been on the Mop Talk too, you may have even met him on occasion. His name is Bill Smith. And Bill is the sole surviving founder member of the Quarrymen Skiffle Group, the band that became the Beatles. And Bill sadly suffered this stroke a few weeks ago, but he's doing okay now. He's recovering slowly but surely. But with that in mind, that's why we decided to do this fundraiser for the Stroke Association. So if you haven't met Bill before, here's a little bit about Bill.
Well, I started there in 1951. Johnny Lennon came the year after. He came in 1952, I think. I'm pretty sure about that. And that was a couple of years later down the line because, yeah, you kick off in that school when you're 11, just getting close to 12 years of age, and then we caught up a couple of years later. Must have been 13, I suppose, 13, 14. I'll have to get the school report out to verify these figures. I mean, out of the top of my head, I don't know. But we did enjoy the school days. A good laugh a minute. He'd been talking to his closest friend, Mr. Peter Shotton. They had had a discussion, I believe, with somebody else before that. I can't think of the guy's name now. We had that little meeting outside the school woodwork room in the yard. John Lennon, Shotton and myself, about forming this little group. That's how I saw it. And Eric Griffiths, I think, he pitched up as well. And Johnny Lennon wanted to call it something. I've said, no, I don't fancy that. The Quarrymen, what we must call it. It's, and he didn't want to know, but he didn't put up too much of a moan about it. And the other two, Shotton and Eric, he said, no, that's the best, you know, this Quarrybank High School here. Yeah, the Quarrymen sounds good. So that's what happened.
So there you go, a little bit about Bill Smith, the sole surviving founder member of the Quarrymen Skiffle Group. And we wish him well on his recovery from his stroke. If you haven't met Teddy before, this is Teddy. And this is Harry. Come here, Harry, come and say hi. Here he is. Teddy and Harry, who were staying with us over the Christmas period. Aren't they cute? Say hello, Harry. Anyway, we're going to come to our next video now. And this is one from the archive, actually. Some of you may have seen this before. It's one of my favourite videos that we've ever done, this one. And the reason for this is it's because we got lots of people involved in this video from every corner of the globe. And we're really pleased to have everybody involved with this. So it's one from the archive, and I'm sure you'll enjoy this one. Even if you have seen it before, you'll enjoy seeing this again. It's Around the World with Peggy Sue. Around the World with Peggy Sue, and a big thank you to everybody who got involved with that video, sending in your versions of Peggy Sue from every corner of the globe. And a special, extra special thanks to our two celebrities on there, which were Len Gary of the Quarrymen Skiffle Group, and of course Billy J. Kramer. That was the actual real life Billy J. Kramer, who kindly supported us with that video. Isn't that cool? Brilliant. Anyway, next we've got another video from the archive, and This one is actually from 2010. It's one of our very earliest videos that we ever made. And I was actually filming this with my son, James. And this is actually an outtake from a video that we made in Madryn Street. And the question is, who cracked first?
Hello, Beatles buddies. Welcome to Liverpool. Stevie T here with you today, bringing you a special treat, because today we're out and about with the video camera.
So, what do you think? Who cracked first? Was it me or was it James? I've always said it was James who cracked first, but you can let us know in the comments below what you think. And if you do put a comment in the box below, remember, that'll put you into the free prize draw to win our fabulous Mop Top Tours goodie bag, which we'll be drawing on New Year's Eve. Anyway, we're going to come now to the highlight of the show for me, I think, which is bringing to you our Christmas single. Yes, our charity Christmas single entitled Peace and Love from Liverpool at Christmas, which was written by myself and the Lagoodles. And we put all this together, ready for this Christmas show this evening. And we've done a special video, especially for tonight, which has got the subtitles running along underneath, so you can sing along at home. And what we'd love you to do, if we can stop these two from fighting, what we'd love you to do is make a little video of yourself singing along to this. Okay, you've got the words to help you. And post your videos underneath this video, and we can have a look at everybody around the world singing along to Peace and Love for Liverpool. It'll be a bit of fun. And if you do put a post on this, we'll certainly put you into the draw as well. Okay, so here we go then. Our special Christmas song, Peace and Love from Liverpool at Christmas.
I'm sorry. sarà Natale migliore, ritroveremo il suo candore, spinti dalla forza dell'amore.
So did you enjoy that? Peace and Love from Liverpool by Le Goodles and Company, our charity single for the Stroke Association. I hope you've made a donation. If you haven't yet, check out the link below. Even if you just leave a pound, that'll help us. We put a lot of work into that video, by the way. It took me all of about 20 minutes to write the lyrics. But then Pino and his boys put the music together. And the video, and we've also, there's some other people on that in the and company part of it, because our grandchildren were on it, or some of them, Jessica, Alfie and Joseph, those three were on it, were three of our grandchildren, and Mrs. T was on it as well at the end. We wanted to do a little doff of the cap to John and Yoko, so at the end of the song, we put in that little Merry Christmas at the end. Did you spot it? That was me and Mrs. T doing our John and Yoko. And we had a bit of fun doing that. So, yeah, it's all good stuff. So don't forget, if you haven't done it already, have a little sing-along to it. Do a video and post that below. And we'll also put you into the free prize draw for that as well. If you put a video on, be brilliant. Anyway, here's something quite exciting for you. I'm going to tell you now about our free prize draw, which we're going to be doing on New Year's Eve. We're going to do the draw to win a fantastic little selection of goodies, which I'm going to show you now, some of these things. What we're going to do, I'll just quickly show you what we've got. Some of the things that's in this Mop Top Tours goodie bag. We have got a Penny Lane t-shirt. Upside down, which has been kindly donated by Julie at the Penny Lane Development Trust. So thanks, Julie, lovely of you. And some of the bits and pieces, a yellow submarine badge, which is really cool. We have a Mop Top Tours souvenir guidebook, which has got in there it tells you all about the tours, but it also has in there the Beatles pump tour guide and a little section on how to speak Scouse. Okay, so if you come into Liverpool, you'll be able to communicate with the locals. What else have we got? We've got this lovely John Lennon pen in the package. We've got some sweets from Strawberry Field. We've got this another thing from Penny Lane, again donated by the Penny Lane Development Trust. It's a Christmas tree hanger, which is quite nice. And a Penny Lane fridge magnet as well. And some more sweets from Strawberry Field. So a nice little souvenir box, little tin to keep them. A Strawberry Field twig pen, or pencil it is, yeah. And we've also got this as well, which is a wonderful CD by the Le Goodles. How cool is that? Wonderful. I mean, the artwork on this is enough. It's just fantastic, can you see? And it's got pictures inside of Le Goodles and Company. And it's been autographed as well by the Le Goodles, all signed there for you. And it's a wonderful prize as part of the Mop Top Tours goodie bag, which comes in this nice little tote bag. Okay, so those are the goodies. All you have to do to be in a chance of winning this goodie bag is just leave a comment underneath the video. Just say hi or season's greetings, whatever you want to say. And your name will be put into the draw. And to give you a chance to get into the draw, we'll do the draw on New Year's Eve. And we'll announce that on the Mop Top Tours Facebook page on New Year's Eve.
don't need the loving. You don't need no bad band. You don't need a horoscope or a microscope to see the mess that you're in. If you open up your heart, you will know what I mean. We've been blue this long. Now it's a way for you to get it clear. By chanting the names of the Lord, you'll be free. The Lord is a way on your heart to awaken and see. You don't need a passport, and you don't need a visa. You don't need a designator to emigrate before you can see Jesus. If you open up your heart, you see it's right there. Always was and will be. He relieve you of your hope. By chanting the names of the Lord, then you'll be free. The Lord is the way on your heart to awaken and see. Chanting the names of the Lord, then you'll be free. The Lord is the way on your heart to awaken and see. You don't need a church house, and you don't need a temple. You don't need a rose appears on the books to read to see that you have fallen. If you open up your heart, you will know what I mean. We'll be kept down so long. Some think that we all grim. And what the Pope holds is the 1% of general mortals. The Lord is a way on your heart to awaken and see. By chanting the names of the Lord, and you'll be free.
Here's a film we made a few years ago, Pino and I. We've had numerous collaborations on mini documentaries we've made over the years. Some of these you may have seen, you may not have done. If you haven't seen our mini documentaries, check out the Facebook page, go into videos, and you'll see a selection of videos that we've made over the years, some mini documentaries. But this one we thought we'd share with you this year because it's got a bit of a Christmassy feel to it. It's a film all about the British comedian George Formby. And certainly on British television, when it gets to this time of year, you tend to see quite a few George Formby films on the TV. And we've made this little mini documentary about George Formby, really though, because he was a favourite of the Beatles. In fact, not a lot of people know this, but if you watch the Free as a Bird video, at the very end of the Beatles Free as a Bird video, you'll see a chap on the stage and it's got a voice that comes on that says, "Turned out nice again." Well, that's George Formby. So it was a doff of the cap to George Formby from the Beatles. So you've got an idea who he is now. But this little mini documentary will tell you all about him in the footsteps of George Formby.
I'm the ukulele man. Come and listen if you can. Children love to hear me play. They even make their mother stay and stand and listen all the day to the ukulele man.
George Formby was an artist that influenced George and John as well.
George Formby, he started off in musical, going around all the different theatres, and he was a regular at the Empire Theatre in Liverpool right through the 1940s and the 50s. He'd also as well made a lot of comedic films, comedy films, which just brought George Formby once again to the mainstream public going to watch his films, because cinema at the time was the big place to go. It was either dance halls or cinemas where you'd go to entertain and to just go out. So George Formby was one of the top paid entertainers in England in the 1940s and 50s. The Beatles themselves, being young children, they would have been interested in George Formby because George Formby was one of their idols. Also as well with the ukulele, playing the ukulele as well, they all started playing the ukulele. Like John's famous dad, his mum Julia, taught him how to play the ukulele. And then when John met Paul, Paul realised that John was playing banjo chords on the guitar. So it was Paul that said, how come you're playing banjo chords? And he said, because I learnt on the ukulele. My mum taught me how to play it. So the George Formby influence has always been with the Beatles. The Liverpool connection with George Formby was that his mum lived in the Sefton Park area of Liverpool. And George Formby had a mistress who lived a couple of houses away from his mum. So George Formby used to visit Liverpool on a regular basis. And when George died, he died in Preston, a heart attack. But his mum organised a funeral in Liverpool, and the funeral took place in Egbeth in the Roman Catholic Church of St Charles Bromcombe. Hundreds of thousands of people came out to watch the cortege for George Formby's funeral. There's a lot of photograph information on the internet. If you go onto the internet, you'll see all the photographs. But unfortunately for the Beatles, they had an afternoon gig in the Cavern the same time as the funeral. So even though George was one of their biggest idols, the Beatles couldn't go to see the cortege because they was actually had a gig in the Cavern the same afternoon. And I think they've mentioned that in the past in different interviews and documentaries when they talk about George Formby personally.
You'll hear me softly singing, it's all about you. You are always on my mind, dear, no matter where I'm up to stray. There's not another girl in all this great big world, that's why I want to say, baby, baby, you're my sweetheart.
Turned out nice again, hasn't it?
Did you enjoy that? Good, wasn't it? Well, I hope you're having a great time tonight and having a wonderful Christmas Eve so far. Wherever you are in the world, having fun at Christmas. We're certainly having a wonderful time here in Liverpool on the Mop Top Tours Christmas Show 2021. Hope you're having fun. Anyway, coming up next, we have more music for you. From the fabulous Lagoodles, this is from their latest album, Any Road Will Take You There, a tribute to George Harrison, and this is the title track. Enjoy. Any Road Will Take You There. This is the album by the Lagoodles. Isn't that fantastic? And you can get this on Amazon. And it's a fabulous album. Look at it. Even the artwork's brilliant in this. Absolutely superb. Wonderful production. So get yourselves onto Amazon if you want to hear more from the Lagoodles. A special treat for you now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. We recently had a little trip to London, as you probably know. And so tonight we thought we'd bring you a special treat with some Beatles sights of London for you. Okay, so if you've never been to London before, you'll enjoy this little video of some of the sights from the Beatles Trail in London.
Shout and swim about the coral that lies beneath the
And a massive thank you to everyone who's left a donation so far for us, for our chosen charity this year, which is the Stroke Association. Click the link under the video. It's the link that takes you through to our Just Giving page. And whatever donation you can leave, large or small, it will be very much appreciated. Thank you so much for all your support. Anyway, coming up next, some season's greetings from Liverpool from some of the people that you may bump into on a mop top tour.
Everyone, here the Busker from Liverpool. Happy Christmas to everyone. Mop Top Tours. Wasn't that great? Thanks to everybody who got involved with that, making those recordings for us and sending season's greetings around the world. Fantastic. And I hope you all enjoyed that watching at home as well, or wherever you may be tonight. Anyway, thanks again to everybody who's left a donation so far. Keep those donations rolling in, won't you?
Thank you so much for supporting the Stroke Association.
For all your support.
Thank you.
For supporting the work of the Stroke Association.
Thank you so much.
Thank you again to everyone who's left us a donation so far. If you haven't left your donation yet, be sure to check out the link underneath the video and you can do a donation for us. Or if you prefer just to pay it in cash, you can give it to me if you see me out and about, and I'll make sure that that gets through to the Just Giving page, and I'll give you credit on there as well, of course. Of course I will. Anyway, coming up next, this is one of my favourite features of the show this evening. These are very fun to me because it's our memories of 2021. And these videos we've been making for about the past 10 years, since 2010, in fact, when we first got a digital camera and started taking a few snaps of some of our tour guests on the Mop Top tours. And then at the end of the year, put all the pictures together with some music to make our memories videos. And we're very proud to have these going back to 2010. And I hope you enjoyed this one from this year. That's the Mop Top Tours Memories of 2021. I hope you enjoyed that as much as we did as well. Fantastic. And thanks to everybody who did join us on a Mop Top Tour this year. And a special thank you to everybody on the Beatles Trail as well. Some of those people who were featured in that previous video doing their season's greetings. Thanks to everybody on the Beatles Trail. Anyway, that just about brings us to the end of the show this evening. So I'd like to thank everybody for joining in with the antics. Thanks to everybody as well who's made a donation. If you haven't made a donation yet, remember to click that link under the video and send us a donation. Every penny counts. And also remember as well, of course, to enter the free prize draw to win the wonderful Mop Top Tours goodie bag. All you need to do, remember, just click underneath the video, leave a comment, and you'll go into the prize draw, which will be drawn on New Year's Eve, and we'll announce that right here on the Mop Top Tours Facebook page. So that's about it for tonight. So again, thanks for joining us. Have a wonderful Christmas. Have a happy New Year. And peace and love from everybody here. We'll see you on the other side. Bye for now. I'm sending you peace and love.
Questo sarà Natale migliore, ritroveremo il suo candore, spinti tra